So when we're doing double-digit subtraction, we have three strategies that we learned this week. The stacking strategy, which you're going to be most familiar with. It's probably what you learned in school. The base 10 strategy and the number line strategy. So let's start with stacking strategy. We're going to do 72 minus 45. We have a little chant so that they set up their equation correctly. It goes, stack them up, big one on top. Draw your line, check your sign. So that teaches them that the large number goes on the top, the smaller number goes on the bottom. They draw their equal line, and then they check their sign to make sure that they have the right math equation. Okay, then from there, you know that we start on the ones place side. So starting here, we have a chant to see if we can just go ahead and automatically subtract or if we need to borrow from the other side. This week, they're all mixed up. Some have regrouping that needs to happen and some do not. So we do the chant that says, more on the top, no need to stop. So here I see a 2 on the top and a 5 on the bottom. Now, since my 2 is smaller, I cannot do that chant. However, if I had 76 minus 45, the 6 is larger than the 5. There's more on the top, so I don't need to stop and go next door to borrow. But let's take for this one, the one that has more on the bottom. So it says more on the floor, go next door and get 10 more. So we go to the tens place of the top number, and we know that this 7 represents 70. Since the 7 is in the tens place and each place can only have one digit, 7 represents 70. Now we take 10 from next door. So this is essentially saying 70 minus 10. If your child cannot do this within 3 seconds, then I would practice skip counting by tens up and down and then asking them what is 10 less, what is 10 more. So 70 minus 10 is 60, and we represent that with one digit in the tens place, which is a 6. And then I teach them that the 10 is floating in the air. We have to grab it. We always clap above our head, grab it, and then add it to your ones place. So then instead of a 2, we're essentially taking 10, which we just borrowed, plus 2. And same thing here. If your child can't answer within 3 seconds or pretty much immediately, then I would practice 10 plus any single digit number. They should be able to do this very quickly. Okay, now 10 plus 2 is 12. So I teach them to cross off the 2 and write the 12. And then they take 12, take away 5. Now, we should not have math errors here. So if they need to draw a picture, they need to count on their fingers, anything that they need to do, whatever strategy to make sure that they're correct. Okay, 12 minus 5 is 7. And then they go to their tens place. 6 take away 4 is 2. So that's the strategy you're probably used to. That's the strategy that I'm used to, and a lot of the kids prefer to do this strategy. What they get confused with is this part. They need to figure out when they need to go next door and borrow and when they can just start. A lot of them also, when they're doing 72, take away 45, they like to just look at these places and then switch the numbers in their head. So they're saying, oh, well, I can take 2 away from 5. So that would be 3. And then 7 minus 4 is 3. But you can see that is the incorrect answer because you have to borrow from the tens place. Okay, so that's stacking strategy. The base 10 strategy we learned today. Base 10 is drawing a picture starting with your largest number, so 72. So we would draw our picture with base 10 blocks. Your long tens rods is just a big line. We're going to draw 7. Representing 70, 60, 70. And then we're going to draw 2 ones cubes, which we do in partners, side by side with a circle. Then I'm going to look at my second number and subtract 45. Now I can't subtract 45 from this picture because I only have 2 in my ones place. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to exchange this one tens rod for 10 single ones. I'm going to draw a second picture for that. Excuse me. So I go ahead and cross this 10 off to remind me I am making that into 10 single ones. 3, 4, 5, 6. Then my seventh one, remember, is my exchange for the tens. And then always remember your extra ones from your first picture. Okay, now I still have the number 72. It's just broken up differently. Then from there, I can take my number and subtract 45. So I can take 4 tens away. 10, 20, 30, 40. And then I can take 5 ones away. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I can see my answer will be 2 tens and 7 ones, 27. So that's the base 10 strategy. And then the last strategy that we learned this one yesterday, is the number line strategy. So you're going to make a number line on your paper. Remember, this is just a segment of your number line, so it should have arrows on both sides. I'm going to rewrite the question over here so you can see it. Okay, there's what we're trying to figure out. We can use related addition to help us figure out the subtraction fact. So we can write 45 plus question mark equals 72. All right, your lowest number goes on the left, and your higher number goes on the right. This is the number we're starting with. This is the number we're trying to get to. Same as my addition equation right there. And since you know number lines, you know as I go to the right, my numbers increase. From here, you're going to skip count by tens without passing this number. Again, if your child is having trouble with skip counting, practice going up and down. We're going to skip count by tens, but we're going to start at 45. So I teach them to have their fist ready. Well, that's really close, sorry. And then we're going to skip count, but we cannot go past 72. So 45, 55, 65. And then I can't do 75 because that's too much. So I can only do 2 jumps of 10. So I'm going to make my hop. And I said 2 jumps of 10, so that's 20. And then I landed at 65, because 45 plus 2 jumps of 10 is 65. Okay, now we're still quite a ways from 72. So we need to figure out what the nearest 10 is for 65. I always have them tell me the 2 tens that 65 is in between. It's in between 60 and 70. So what's the next 10? And they would tell me it's 70. So I'm going to write 70 on the line. And then I have to figure out how many jumps it takes from 65 to 70. Well, that's 5 jumps. So I label that with a 5. And then, I kind of drew this really long. Oh well. And then I have to figure out how many jumps from 70 to 72, which is 2. And then the way you find your answer is by counting and adding all of your hops together. So 20 plus 5 plus 2 equals 27. So those are the 3 strategies that we learned this week. If you have any questions, just let me know and I'll walk you through them. Thanks for watching.